back in the day, I tended to buy way too many clothes than I actually needed. So what I decided to do was vow to never buy another hanger ever again. So what I do when I get new clothes, I take old clothes out of my closet that I either no longer wear anymore or feel like they could be better used somewhere else, bring them to Goodwill, move the new stuff in. It's a win-win. Hi.
So quick update on the car search. I decided that since this car is still running, I might as well just wait until after winter to buy something. At least that's what my plan is as of now. Now, my check engine light is on. I'm gonna see if I can get that checked out. Who knows what that might be. If it's something that it costs a lot of money, I might just speed up the process. I don't really know. Hey, what do you know about a Cadillac converter?
You know, my whole life I thought it was Cadillac converter. I guess it's catalytic converter or something. I know nothing about cars. Oh, you excited? Do you like it? Jackpot. And if you hold me, I won't mind it. And I don't know you, but I want to. And if this plane fell to the water, I'm okay. We'll ride the waves of the ocean. It's all this protein bar at Kroger has essentially the same macros as a Quest bar. Anytime I see something like this, I like to pick it up in case you guys are curious. I would say definitely not as good, and it wasn't that cheap, honestly. Can't say I'd really recommend this one, but if you're in a pinch, it'll do the trick. I keep my head afloat. I'ma keep my head afloat. What's up, Rich Homies? Just want to give you a fair warning. I might be utilizing some video footage that I recorded last week into this video just because it didn't fit into the video that I was doing from that day, so I didn't want it to go to waste. And in my opinion, it's no big deal. Like, I could have edited it all together and made it seem like it was all from this day, but I didn't want to lie to you. But some people will try to, you know, call me out that it takes me a long time to get video footage out. A lot of my footage is a week old. And does it really matter? I look at it like music. It should be timeless. Like, the best songs, in my opinion, are those that were made maybe like 20, 30 years ago, and they're still extremely relevant today, just like these videos. You should be able to watch this video last week or 2 years from now, and it should have the exact same meaning. I'm still getting up 3 videos a week, and I could get videos out in real time if, well, if a few different things. I didn't have this thing, what's it called? A job. Yeah, I gotta go to that thing. And if enough of you guys liked my videos, shared it with all your friends, and I got, you know, tons and tons of views and all this money from YouTube, I could quit my job, get you guys real-time footage. But that's not happening. I don't know you, but I want to. And if this plane fell to the water, I'm okay. We'll ride the waves of the ocean, wasting all of our days. So you probably saw this in the last video, this Lions pack. I told you guys I'd be trying it out. Decided to put it on a few waffles here, and I did take a sneak bite, which I feel like a lot of people do on YouTube. Like, you're curious before you actually do the on-camera taste test, but it was just like a little baby one, right? And I can tell you, I think I'm really gonna like this stuff. I would say there's not a lot of products that really exceed my expectations. I mean, I like a lot of stuff. I'm not very picky, but to actually overly impress me is pretty tough. This might be one of those products because it tastes great. Chocolate chip cookie is fantastic, obviously. It's a vegan product, which you would never know it, but it's cool because everyone can eat this. And I'm just reading the back here. It's like all natural ingredients, which is a plus for a lot of people. And then it says 10% of this order was donated to the Dream to Achieve Kids Foundation. So they give back, and it's a family-run business. I'm not promoted with these guys at all, by the way. I'm not getting paid for this. If you do want to buy this, though, I think you can save money through Amanda Bucci's code. I'm pretty sure she has a discount code, which I'll put on the screen. But man, I mean, it's a little bit different texture-wise, but I will definitely be enjoying this as well as the other flavors. Guess we might as well keep it going with the vegan thing. I'm gonna have one of these Lenny and Larry's cookies just because I have a ton of these things. I got a lot of questions on what I'm gonna be doing with my diet now that I'm hurt. I can't really train that hard. Am I gonna be cutting? Am I gonna be bulking? What will I be doing exactly? How am I eating? Because I know a lot of what you see now are these food challenges, and I know that's probably not a good representation of what I'm doing on a daily basis. So hopefully this video will give you an idea. So something very interesting just happened. My neighbor, who's a super nice guy, never asked me for anything, walks over, I'm out mowing the grass, and he's like, can you help me lift this keg into my truck? It's my daughter's wedding, and I gotta get going. And of course, I'm like, oh my gosh, out of all times. He's never asked me for anything, and I honestly, I had too much pride to say no, and
I feel fine, but it's just stupid, you know? Like, I should not be lifting a keg. This thing was, I mean, I didn't bend over to lift it up. I just lifted up with my arms mostly, but I think that's probably one of the most frustrating situations I faced since injuring my back. And I think that's more motivating than even getting back into deadlifting. Just being able to do things like that. That was pretty eye-opening. As you can see, still eating very high volume meals. Spaghetti squash never looks good, but it turns out pretty well if you add a bunch of stuff to it. You saw that I added some vegetables, some tomatoes, some peppers, and some chili cheese dogs, which are fantastic. Now, I'm going to be in a caloric surplus. When I say going to be, because I am not there yet, I can tell because I'm still going down on the scale, but it's just trial and error because after switching from powerlifting, my energy expenditure has been a lot higher. I told you guys I've been getting my 10,000 steps every single day, by the way. Pretty proud of that. And the workouts themselves are just, I burn more calories. Powerlifting, if you think about it, you're just sitting around a lot. You're doing maybe 2 to 3 reps. You're not burning near the amount of calories as you are with hypertrophy work. So I'm still trying to figure out what my maintenance is, and then I will adjust my macros from there. I do realize the randomness of this. It's just mac and cheese I had left over. I don't know about you guys, but I happen to love leftovers. I know there's certain people out there that will not eat them at all, which kind of blows my mind. I mean, leftovers, it's like the joys of eating without the cooking or the cleaning. It's perfect. It's crazy to think about. One cup of this stuff has 20 grams of fat. Now, most people would not eat just one cup, you know? So I think that's where a lot of people get themselves in trouble. As far as myself, I think I'm going to be setting my macros at about 70 grams of fat. Not really sure on carbs yet. Like I told you guys, I'm still trying to play around with calories. That'll be the filler. And then protein at about 200. So we'll see how that goes for a week or so. And obviously, you guys know I have plenty of untracked meals. If you watch my homemade fast food video, you would know that I love the dessert Crunchwrap Supreme. It is so easy, it's so simple. So we're gonna make an all protein version. So what we're gonna do is add 1 cup of Greek yogurt and then 1 scoop of the vanilla PS. And you know you can always save 30% using the link down below, or just type in Travis at checkout. And we're also going to add one of these grenade bars. This thing legitimately tastes like a candy bar. They are so good. So I just got that mixed in the bowl, probably crumple this up, put it in there, fold it up. And unfortunately, we throw this guy into the freezer for about half hour, 45 minutes, but trust me, it's worth the wait. So if you have the patience to wait long enough, and trust me, I know how hard it is, it comes out a lot better in the freezer. I'm going to share with you guys the art of getting a thumbnail picture. So I'm gonna have to take some bites to get this thing even. Try to lift this guy up a little bit, make sure you can see all the good filling in there. Even kept a little bit of the leftover protein bar so it looks a little bit more enticing that way. I swear, sometimes I just try to get away with marketing, you guys, but it's always for a good cause. And after all the hard work is done, at least you get to enjoy this delicious creation. So the reason I don't make, I guess you call them normal full day of eating videos anymore. It's just because I feel like they're not exciting. I've done so many of them, and I know some of you still get some value out of them. You like to have different ideas, different things you can implement in your diets. It's hard, I know. Let the music take over, baby. So that's kind of my dilemma right now. I want to provide you guys with videos you enjoy, but also I want to enjoy making them too. And I can't say I really enjoy making this style of video, but I'll take one for the team. So let me know your feedback down below.
All I really know is I am never going to get tired of this stuff.
Macros for the day, 210 protein, 350 carbs, and around 80 grams of fat, which seems pretty reasonable. Like I said, I'm still trying to figure some things out here. And in my opinion, it is not in your best interest to be in a caloric deficit if you're injured. Now is not the time to get shredded. There's going to be plenty of time for that later on. But maybe being at maintenance or in a slight surplus, now that might come with some excess body fat. Who knows? Because you're not going to be able to train your hardest. But I would much rather fuel my body, give it the nutrients it needs to help recover, and err on that side. Because I can always lose fat. That's easy to do, right? I mean, it's calories in versus calories out. My main focus is getting better, and I think that's probably what's gonna be the best option for most people. So hopefully this video helps some of you guys out. Thank you so much for taking the time out of your day to watch. You could have been doing anything, and you chose to spend a few minutes with me. That is pretty awesome. Please give the video a like if you enjoyed it. It really does help me out a lot, and I look forward to talking to you guys next time.